Hi guys, welcome to my next tutorial. Today I would like to show you my new project. I know that lots of people waiting for this actually project, so I've done big round pineapple tablecloth. It measures about 44 inches in diameter, so it, as you can see on the picture, is quite big. And you will need for this tutorial crochet hook 1.75 mm and the crochet thread yarn number 10. I'm not quite sure how many balls of this yarn I use, but something about 4 or 5. As I said, it's quite a big project, so it will take you lots of time. So let's get started. Our work, we need to start by making slip knot. And then chain of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we need to make slip stitch into the first chain to make ring. So we've got ring here, and into that ring we will start working double crochets. But at the beginning of round number one, we will have to make chain of 3. This is the first double crochet, the next two double crochet into the ring. Next two double crochets into the ring. So 1 and 2. Now chain of 3, 1, 2, 3, and 3 double crochets into the ring. 1, 2, and 3. Chain of 3, another 3 double crochets into the ring. 1, 2, and 3. Chain of 3. So now actually we need to repeat our pattern, making 3 double crochets into the ring and then chain of 3 5 more times. So at the end of our round we should have 8 groups of 3 double crochets and 8 chain 3 spaces. At the end of our round we need to make slip stitch into the third chain, 1, 2, and 3, so into the top of the first double crochet. And now round number 2. We have to start by making slip stitch into the second stitch, so we have to be in the center of our 3 double crochets together. And now chain of 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then slip stitch into the chain space, chain of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, slip stitch into the second double crochet, chain of 4, slip stitch into the chain space, chain of 4, slip stitch into the second double crochet. So now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. Chain of 4, slip stitch into the chain space, chain of 4, slip stitch into the second stitch, into the second double crochet. At the end of our round, we need to work slip stitch exactly into the same stitch as we've done the slip stitch on the previous round. So that can be a little bit hard. Into the same stitch and then into the next two chains. So into the first one chain, into the second chain. Now slip stitch into the center of our first chain space. So now we will start round number 3. And now we are into the center, chain 1 as a first single crochet, then chain of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we are going to the next chain space and we need to work single crochet. Chain of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, into the next chain space, single crochet, chain of 4, into the next chain space, single crochet, chain of 4 into the next chain space, single crochet. So again, now we need to repeat it all the way around. Chain of 4 and single crochet into the next chain space. At the end of our round, we need to work slip stitch into the first chain, so into the our first single crochet, and then one slip stitch into the next chain. So now we will start next round. 1, 2, 3, round number 4. Into the round number 4, first we have to work chain of 3, and then we will work 5 double crochets together, but because we need to start our row, this time we will work only 4 double crochets together. So into the our chain space, we will work only the first part of the double crochet. The last loop need to stay on the hook. So then we need to repeat this thing 3 more times. We are working through first 2 loops and the last loop is staying on the hook. So we've got 2, 3 and 4. We've got at the moment 5 loops on the hook, and now we can finish the stitch, chain 1 for lock this stitch. Now chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We are going to the next chain space and we need to work the same 5 double crochets together. So 5 times only the first part of the double crochet. So each time we need to leave the last loop. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now we should have 6 loops on the hook because 1 loop is from chain stitch. Now we can finish the stitch and chain of 1 for close that stitch. So now again chain of 5, into the next chain space the same 5 double crochets together. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Six loops on the hook, then chain 1 for lock the stitch and chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the same pattern we need to repeat in each chain space all the way around. 5 double crochets together. At the end of our round, we need to make a slip stitch onto the top of 4 double crochets together. So we are not working slip stitch into the top of chain 3, but straight into the big stitch and the, just above the 4 double crochets. Now we will start round number 5. So chain 1 as a single crochet, then chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Single crochet into the chain space, then chain of 5, single crochet onto the top of 5 double crochets together. So again into that big loop. Chain of 5, single crochet into the chain space, chain of 5, single crochet into the top of 5 double crochets together. So each time now we need to make work chain of 5, then single crochet into the chain space, then chain of 5, single crochet into the next group of 5 double crochets together. So now we have to repeat this pattern all the way around. At the end of our round, we need to make slip stitch into the first chain, so into the single crochet, and then we will work slip stitch into the second chain and into the third and into the fourth. So now we have to be into the center of our chain space. Now we will start making chain of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and slip stitch into the chain space, or actually single crochet, yeah, single crochet, chain of 4, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of 4, single crochet into the next chain space, and now we have to repeat this pattern all the way around. So in this chain space we have to work single crochet and then chain 4. So now at the end of our run, again slip stitch into the first chain, so into the single crochet, and we need to start round number 7. So round number 7 we will start by making slip stitch into the chain space and then 5 double crochets together. But we need to start by making chain of 3, so into the first chain space we will work only 4 double crochets together. So exactly the same as we've done on this round. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times first part of the double crochet, so we should have 5 loops on the hook. Now we can finish the stitch, chain 1 for lock this stitch. Now chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We are going to the next chain 3 space and we need to make the same. 5 double crochets together. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now we can finish the stitch and then chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now we are going to the next chain space and we have to make the same. 5 double crochets into the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We need to work through all loops, chain 1 for lock. So now this pattern we need to work in each chain space. We have to work 5 double crochets together and then chain of 5. At the end of our round we need to work slip stitch into the top of double crochets together, so into that big loop. And now we have to start round number 8. We will make slip stitch into the first 3 chains. 1, 2, 3 and 3. So now we are into the center of chain 5 space and we will start working exactly the same as on the previous round. So chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we will work slip stitch into the next chain 5 space. Or maybe instead of making slip stitch we will work single crochet. I think it will be better. So single crochet into the next chain 5 space and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, single crochet into the next chain 5, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, single crochet into the next chain 5 space. So now we have to repeat making pattern chain of 5 and then single crochet into the next chain 5 space all the way around. At the end of our round we need to work slip stitch into the same stitch as we've done slip stitch on the previous round, and now we will work slip stitch into the next 3 chains, or into the first 2, 1, 2 and then slip stitch into the chain space. So now we are in the center of chain, first chain space. We need to work chain of 3, so first double crochet and then one more double crochet into the same chain space, chain of 1 and 2 more double crochets, 1 and 2. So we've done some kind of V-stitch by making 2 double crochets, chain 1 and 2 double crochets. Now chain of 1, we are going to the next chain space and we will work the same. 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, chain 1 and 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. Chain of 1 into the next chain space, 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, then chain of 1 and 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, chain of 1. So now in each chain space we have to work V stitch by making 2 double crochets, chain 1 and 2 double crochets, then chain of 1 and we are going to the next chain 5 space. And now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. I am at the end of my round, so now we need to work slip stitch into the third chain, 1, 2 and 3. And now we will start round number 10. So now slip stitch into the second double crochet and slip stitch into the chain 1 space between two groups of two double crochets. Now we have to work chain of 3, then one more double crochet into the same chain space, chain of 1 and 2 more double crochets into the same chain, 1 and 2. So into our V-stitch from the previous round we've done a rather the same V-stitch, 2 double crochets, chain 1 and 2 double crochets. Now we need to skip 2 double crochets and then chain 1, then next 2 double crochets. We will work chain of 2 and into the next V-stitch we will work the same V-stitch. So 2 double crochets, chain of 2 and 2 more double crochets, 1 and 2. Now chain of 2, into the next V-stitch we will work V-stitch again, 1 and 2, 2 double crochets, chain 1 and 2 double crochets. So now chain of 2 again and we need to repeat our pattern all the way around. So in each V-stitch we will work V-stitch then chain of 2. At the end of our round we have to work slip stitch into the third chain, so into the top of our first double crochet, and now round number 11. So again we need to make slip stitch into the second stitch and then into the chain 2 space, into the chain 1 space, so into the space between two groups of two double crochets. Now we will work V stitch again, so chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then double crochet, chain 1 and 2 more double crochets, 1 and 2. Now chain of 3, 1, 2, 3 and then V-stitch into the next V-stitch, 2 double crochets, chain of 1 and 2 more double crochets, 1 and 2, chain of 3, 1, 2, 3. So again, now in each V-stitch we will work V-stitch and then chain of 3. So 2 double crochets, chain 1, then 2 double crochets and then chain of 3. So we need to repeat this pattern all the way around to the end of round number 11, and round number 12 we have to work exactly the same. So at the end of our round number 11 we will work slip stitch into the third chain and then we have to start round number 12 exactly the same as we start this round.
So I am at the end of my round number 12. As I said, I've done two rows in the same way, so V-stitch into the V-stitch, then chain of three. Now we will start round number 13. So we need to work slip stitch into the second double crochet and then into the chain space. And we basically we need to work the same, so V-stitch into the V-stitch, so chain of three as a first double crochet, then double crochet into the same chain space, chain one, and two more double crochets into the same chain space. Only one difference between the previous round is that we need to work chain of four, three and four. Then we are going into the next V-stitch and we have to work V-stitch again. So two double crochets, chain one, and two double crochets. Then chain of four, and the same. So basically this pattern we need to repeat all the way around, and then we need to repeat exactly the same on round number 14. So by using this way, this pattern, we need to work another two rows, 13 and 14. I've done my last two rows by making V-stitch into the V-stitch and then chain of four, so I've got at the moment 14 rows. Now we will start round number 14 rounds. So now I will start round number 15. So exactly the same, slip stitch into the second stitch, slip stitch into the chain space. Into the first V-stitch we will work V-stitch, so chain of three, double crochet, chain of one, two double crochets into the chain space, one and two. And now we need to work chain of five, one, two, three, four and five. We are going to the next V-stitch and this time we have to work two double crochets, one and two, then chain of three, and then two more double crochets. So first V-stitch we've done by making chain of one, so exactly the same as on the previous rounds, and now the second one we will work by making chain of three. So now chain of five again, we are going to the next V-stitch and we will work as on the previous round, so two double crochets, one and two, chain one, and another two double crochets, one and two, chain of five, into the next V-stitch, two double crochets, chain three, and two more double crochets, chain of five, one, two, three, four, five, and from now we will start to repeat our pattern from the beginning of our round. So V-stitch with chain of one, into the next V-stitch, V-stitch with chain of three, V-stitch with chain one, then V-stitch with chain three, all the way around. So at the end of our round we should have the last V-stitch with two double crochets, chain three and two double crochets, then chain of five and slip stitch into the top of chain three. Now round number 16, we have to make slip stitch into the second stitch, then slip stitch into the chain one space. Into the V-stitch we will work chain of three, then double crochet, chain of one and two double crochets. So round number 16, we are starting by making V-stitch into the V-stitch, then chain of three, into the V-stitch where we've done chain of three, we will work 10 double crochets, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. So into the same chain space I've done 10 double crochets, so we've got some kind of shell. And now chain of 3 again. Into the next V-stitch with chain 1 space, we will work V-stitch again. So double crochet, second double crochet, chain 1 and 2 more double crochets. 1 and 2. Chain of 3. Now again we've got V-stitch with chain of 3, so we have to work 10 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Chain of 3. So now basically we have to repeat our pattern. In V-stitch with only chain 1 we need to work V-stitch. In V-stitch with chain 3 we have to work 10 double crochets and between each V-stitches we have to make chain of 3. At the end of our round we've done the last 10 double crochets, then chain 3 and slip stitch into the third chain. So now again we have to go to the chain 1 space. Into that chain we will work V-stitch by making chain of 3, then double crochet, chain of 1 and 2 more double crochets. So exactly the same as on the previous rounds. Chain of 3 again. So we've got chain of 3 and now into the first double crochet we will work double crochet, then chain of 1. And 1. Into the next double crochet, chain 1. Into the next double crochet, chain 1. So basically in each stitch we have to make double crochet and then chain 1. So at the end we should have 10 double crochets and 9 chain 1 spaces. Double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, chain 1 and one more time double crochet. After the last double crochet we have to make chain of 3. We are going to the next V-stitch and we need to work V-stitch. Double crochet, then double crochet, chain 1 and 2 more double crochets. 1 and 2. Chain of 3 and we have to repeat our pattern what we've done here. So in each double crochet we have to make double crochet and then chain 1. Then double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, chain 1. So from now we have to repeat what we've done at the beginning of our round all the way around. Okay, so at the end of my round I've done chain of 3 and slip stitch into the first double crochet, so into the top of chain 3. Now we need to start round number 18. So we will make slip stitch into the second double crochet, then into the chain space and we will work V-stitch again. So chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then double crochet into the same chain stitch, chain of 1 and 2 more double crochets into the same chain. So 1 and 2. Now chain of 3, 1, 2, 3. Single crochet into the first double crochet. Then chain of 3, 1, 2 and 3. We need to skip first chain space and into the second we will work single crochet. Then chain of 3, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of 3 and single crochet into the next chain space. So now we will making the same in each chain one space. Chain of three, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of three, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of three, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of three. We need to skip the last chain space and we will work single crochet into the last double crochet. So at the moment we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 chain 3 spaces. Now we have to make chain of three again, 1, 2, 3. Into the next chain space we will work V-stitch. So into the V-stitch, next V-stitch, two double crochets, chain one, and two more double crochets. One and two. Chain of three. And then again, single crochet into the first double crochet. Chain of three, single crochet into the second chain space, chain of three, now single crochet into the next chain space, chain of three, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of three, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of three, then into the next chain space, single crochet, chain three. Two more times single crochet into the next chain space. So one, chain three, single crochet into the next chain space, chain three, and single crochet into the last double crochet. So again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 chain three spaces on our shell. So now we are starting make the pineapple stitches. So this is actually the third row of our pineapple. We've done first 10 double crochets, then 10 double crochets, 9 chain spaces, and now we are working chain spaces. So chain of three into the next shell, into the next V-stitch we have to work V-stitch, and then we have to repeat our pattern from the beginning of our round. At the end of our round we need to work the last chain of three and then slip stitch into the third chain, so into the top of our first double crochet. Now we will start next round, so we have to make, this is I think round 19, slip stitch into the second double crochet, then into the chain space, chain of three as a first double crochet, then double crochet into the same chain, chain one, and two more double crochets. So V stitch into the V stitch again, chain of three, 1, 2, 3, into the first chain, so this chain three space we have to skip, so into the second, actually single crochet, chain of three, into the next chain space, single crochet, chain of three, into the next single crochet, chain of three, into the next, chain of three, then into the next one, chain of three, into the next one, single crochet, then chain of three, into the next, chain of three, and into the last one, chain of three, single crochet. So now we should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 chain three spaces on our pineapple stitch after this chain of three and V stitch into the V stitch, two double crochets, one and two, chain of one, and two more double crochets, one and two, chain of three, single crochet into the second chain free space, and we need to repeat what we've done at the beginning of our round all the way around. So at the end of our round, again we've done the last chain of three and slip stitch into the top of chain three. Now round number 20. So slip stitch into the second double crochet, slip stitch into the chain space, and then we have to start by making V stitch. So chain of three, double crochet into the same stitch, chain of one, and two more double crochets. One and two. Now chain of three again, one, two, three. We have to skip first chain of three into the second single crochet, then chain of three. Into the next chain three single crochet, and then chain three. Into the next one single crochet, and again chain of three. Single crochet into the next chain space, chain of three. Then single crochet into the next one, chain of three, single crochet into the next, chain of three, and single crochet into the last one. So at the moment we've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 chain spaces. Then now another chain of three and V stitch into the V stitch. So two double crochets, chain one, and two more double crochets into the same chain space. Chain of three, single crochet into the second chain three, so we have to skip the first one. We are going into the second, then chain of three, single crochet into the next one. So basically, again, we need to repeat what we've done from the beginning of our round. Round 21, again we need to start by making slip stitch into the second double crochet and then into the chain one space. And now we need to make chain of three as a first double crochet, then second double crochet. Chain one, into the same chain space two double crochets, one and two, then chain one again, and two more double crochets. So this round is a little bit different because in each V stitch we will work six double crochets and two chain one spaces. Now chain of three, one, two and three, we are going to the second chain three, so again first one we need to skip, and we will work single crochet, so the same as on the previous rounds. So chain of three, single crochet into the next chain three space, chain of three, single crochet into the next chain three space, chain of three, single crochet into the next chain three space, chain of three, single crochet into the next chain three space, chain of three, single crochet into the last chain three space of our pineapple stitch. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 chain three spaces. Now chain of three and into the V stitch again, two double crochets, one and two, chain one, another two double crochets, so another two double crochets, chain one, and last two double crochets, one and two. So again six double crochets and two chain one spaces. So now again chain of three, single crochet into the second chain three space, but first in our pineapple stitch, and we need to repeat our pattern all the way around. Okay, so at the end of our round we need to work our the last chain of three and then slip stitch into the top of chain three, so into the first double crochet. Now we will start round
22. So we need to make slip stitch into the second double crochet and then slip stitch into the chain space. Now into the first chain one space we will work V-stitch by making chain of 3, then double crochet, chain of 1 and 2 more double crochets. So exactly the same as V-stitches on the previous rounds. So into the first chain one space V-stitch, then chain of 5 and 5, and into the next chain one space we will work another V-stitch. So 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, then chain of 1 and 2 more double crochets into the same chain space. So we've got 2 V-stitches plus chain 5 space. Now chain of 3. We need to skip first chain 3 space. We are going to the second and we will work single crochet, then chain of 3. Single crochet to the next stitch, next chain space, chain of 3. Single crochet to the next chain space, chain of 3. To the next one, chain of 3 and to the last one single crochet. So at the moment in our pineapple pattern we've done 1, 2, 3 and 4 chain 3 spaces. Now chain of 3, we are going to the next V-stitches and into the first chain 1 space we will work V-stitch, so 2 double crochets, chain 1 and 2 double crochets, chain of 5 and into the next chain 1 space another V-stitch, 2 double crochets, chain of 1 and 2 double crochets. So basically now we need to repeat what we've done from the beginning of our round. We've done this as on the beginning and now we have to start working on the pineapple stitch. So chain of 3 and then we need to continue all the way around.